Well, I think Ghislaine Maxwell was in a situation where she didn't have a choice.
She was part of it. She knew exactly what was going on.
I understand that. However, I think that she was in a situation she couldn't get out of. And she had already been abused herself.
She could have got out of it if she'd wanted to.
And she didn't really have a choice.
Stay in a situation like that.
She was going to lose. She had a lot to lose. She had more to lose than she did gain.
Especially when
by leaving.
Abusing.
Am I right or wrong? I don't know. I know a lot of people that's been in that situation. Not in that sort of a realm.
So have I.
But but in a domestic situation where they can't get out of it, well, they choose not to. Well, and quite frankly, I think that her lawyer would have been smart to use her and say that she was a victim also. I'm not sure why they didn't go with that.
I went to law. I studied law a while, Zack. And, you know, sometimes the lawyers, they just want to win the case. They don't really take into consideration the victims. And, you know, that happens a lot. And I think that would have been a good idea for a lawyer to do, or her attorney. Didn't she have a female attorney?
Yes, I think her name is Bobby Sternheim. And I think Bobby Sternheim is... Sternheim, say it wrong. It's pretty local in New York. She's not a Gloria Allred or any of these other high profile. She is a good lawyer, I think. And I'm like you guys, I'm not real sure why they didn't push that more.
Well, at certain times, you got to go with what you got to work with. She probably wasn't given a lot to work with since there was so much evidence against her. And that sometimes that makes a huge, huge difference in a case. I've studied lots of them, and I know that if you're going to use something, you gotta sit and think about it and research it and make sure that it's there, that the evidence is there. Unless you just want to pull it out of your ass at the end of the trial to try to save your client. But I didn't see that happening because of the money thing.
You're talking about some young victims too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
With that case.
And you had them girls that were there with their lawyers. And you know, that's a big thing to look at when you're trying to defend a woman like that that's had been involved with a pedophile like Epstein. That's, like I said a while ago, you got to kind of go with the flow sometimes. And I don't know, they was going to hang her anyway. I don't think she would ever have a chance being innocent. They would have never let her go. Especially with Epstein being gone and dying in jail.
Yeah, you're right, Shade. Someone was going to pay for that one.
The suicide. Well, Zack ain't going to believe it was suicide.
No, I still don't believe that. Now, there's no way that Jeffrey Epstein committed suicide. Someone, you know, it's just ironic that they...
No, but Zack...
I know, but what happened... It's just ironic that the guards the guards were there and they just happened to go on quote break, and then all of a sudden
you and your conspiracy.
All of a sudden the cameras go out. Come on, man. That's give me a break.
I'm just really wondering where they're gonna send her. You know, they got the ADX out there in Colorado that take all the high profile men like the Unabomber and the I think even your man Sammy the Bull was at the ADX Supermax out there in Colorado.
Yeah, I think Sammy was.
He was.
I think he was there. I heard one of his podcasts say that they had him in the hole in
but I wonder,
Supermax.
I wonder, is that a place for women like that?
God, I hope not.
Yeah, I know, buddy. No, right? I know.
Need that. Just don't need that.
Yeah, I had a friend that was in Supermax. He said, if you didn't like tornadoes, it was a place to be because it was underground. And, It was way down in the ground, and it was, you wouldn't gonna be able to get out. Had your own little pod, you stayed in, and he loved it. I mean, to be a prison.
Yeah,
you know?
Zach, I think I know who you're talking about. You're talking about, yeah. Yeah, he is hardcore. He is hardcore. He probably needs to be there.
Yeah, you met Cowboy Tom, didn't you? Yeah, he's a character. He's a character. He tried to get me to come out there and visit him at Supermax. I said, yeah, he'll pass over. We won't be doing that anytime soon. They might keep me.
yeah.
Zack, they probably would.
Well, you know, Cowboy Tom, my buddy, he got caught up in a RICO, and the racketeering law. And, you know, conspiracies will bury you. If you get caught in a conspiracy, it'll bury you. He just didn't have a good lawyer. That was his problem.